We continue our live team coverage with Action 7 News reporter Megan Cruz. She was first on the scene and arrived just as police were closing off the area. She talked to a number of people who saw the crash.
For those who know this area, you know that it is very busy with pedestrian and vehicle traffic. That's why it is no surprise that so many people saw this very scary situation unfold.
It hit the side of the building so hard that it pieces went everywhere and it started smoking.
Stephanie Litton was walking right past the hospital when the helicopter crashed.
I was on the phone with my mom and I just see the helicopter start taking off like normal, and then it just took off and went kind of towards the side and it turned sideways 100% and just started, the propeller started just taking it with it and almost hit the side of the building.
Sky 7 got this video of it just minutes after it happened. Litton was one of many who witnessed the Wednesday evening crash. Tyler Jackson was walking to his car from class.
It started spinning around in circles, and then it started to teeter a little bit, and I guess the wind caught it or something because it went straight down and hit the building. A bunch of debris came off the building, and you could see fire coming from the helicopter and dark smoke.
He said the crash and the police response afterwards seemed unreal.
I lived right over here in the Laguna Halls, and I've seen it take off and land a ton of times, and I've never seen anything like that.
Both Litton and Jackson say it's a miracle no one walking along Lomas was hurt.
It looked like it was going to miss the building and just hit the street, because if it would have, it would have accelerated even faster and then probably exploded.
The hospital did evacuate the 5th and 6th floors immediately after the crash, but we're told that no one inside the building was hurt. Also, aside from that evacuation, no other patient services were disrupted. Now, the hospital is asking that there be no visitors tonight, but if you do want to check in on a loved one, you can call 272-INFO for any updates. Reporting live in Albuquerque, Megan Cruz, KOAT, Action 7 News.
We've also been told engineers are currently assessing the structural stability of the building.